What is up, guys? Jake from One Hive here with the next war recap video. And I actually got two wars I'm sort of behind right now. So we're going to check it out right here, the Bobson family. You guys got a sneak peek, I guess, of the next war as well. But we'll go through their attacks. They did use most of their attacks and did a good job, so we'll give them that respect. Show what they did to our base. A couple of Town Hall 10 3-stars even. I think some of those were Town Hall 11s diffing down, but still very good job. A lot of Town Hall 9 3-stars, but there's a lot of them that were left un 3-starred, and that obviously was the difference in the war. Going through there, got sort of our bottom ones. And then on our side, we took out all of their Town Hall 11s as far as 2-stars, and then Town Hall 10s was a mixture of 2 and 3-stars, and then, of course, Town Hall 9s, all 3-starred. So let's get to the attacks. Good job to everybody at One Hive. First one we're going to look at is actually just a Town Hall 11 attack. Just want to show you guys some of this. Town Hall 11 action, and these are the type that you want to get right here. This is not a just super maxed out Town Hall 11 or anything, but these high percentage, you know, 2-stars, that's where it's going to be at for a while, I believe. I think that, you know, once we start getting some of these guys with completely maxed out wardens and everything, they have a better chance of getting those 3-stars. But right now, as people are still developing their Town Hall 11 force, it's going to be largely a 2-star game. But we'll see how that goes in the future. So just drops the queen down here, starting off a lot like a Town Hall 10 attack would. See them dropping the quakes there in the core, opening all that up for when the main attack comes in. Wants to have that open and just let everything move its way through, you know, just as quickly as it wants to. Right here, the queen moving down, and then right here, the enemy queen engaging. Got that rage down 4 already, though. That's going to take her out pretty quickly and allow the healers to get her picked back up. So she continues her walk down around the base. Pretty straightforward here, just letting it clear out a section of the base, you know, all those defenses. That's going to also keep the troops, Crispy's troops, from trying to spread out once he enters from here. There's nothing to draw them to the left there. They can go straight up the middle once he gets that opened up and everything moving through. So it's continuing on, just letting the queen do her thing, walking, walking, walking. And here in just a moment, he's going to start the main force of his attack. You see that look at the warden over there hanging out defensive-wise. You can actually see the ring around it of where it's actually giving that boost defensively as well. So right there, the troops start coming on the right side. Just a few wizards to create that little bit of a funnel needed. Not much there because the queen actually created most of it. But you see what I was talking about here, some of those king and queen, king and golem beating on the wall there. As soon as the queen clears all the rest of that out, nothing will make them come down that direction. So only one more troop right there. Everything should reroute. Now everything's going towards that core. Drops that first freeze, and there comes the warden right in there, grouped up with everything. And then here in just a moment, Crispy's going to drop that ability, which gives him that immunity right there. Everything's immune for a few moments, which really gets them catch up, get ahead, and start taking out some of these buildings. See, the town hall is already down 53% already, and there is a ton of troops still up. You see that last Inferno Tower doing a little bit of work, but it is a single, so everything is just being targeted one at a time. All of those witches, skeletons moving through, doing the tanking for the most part. The queen's still untouched, but she is beating through a wall down here. For some reason, she did not reroute with the rest of them. She decided to take the hard way and go right through the walls, but oh well. At least she didn't take any damage during that time, so she continues to move forward. Meets back up with the warden, and pretty much they're the only things left. So we'll fast forward a little bit here, a minute left of that, and a few skeletons, a few witches doing their thing. Why these healers did not peel off and get on this queen kind of sucks, because that one X-boat was targeting that warden. Who knows? Might have got much further into this base, but the warden's not going to do much even with healers on him. But anyways, very high percentage 2-star on that Town Hall 11. Good job to Crispy Crunch. Those are the ones we're looking for right now. Okay, moving on. Let's get to some Town Hall 10 action. And looking at Megan Mo Money getting the 3-star on their number 7. Doing it with the Golalun and doing it with a normal queen walk as an opener, and then a few freezes, a few rages, and whatnot. Always having those rages for the queen when needed, and then if you don't need them, you can use them for the rest of your attack. Up top there, dropping that giant down and a few wizards just to create the funnel. Make sure the queen goes where you want her to. You see she's getting pretty low right here. Needs to get that point defense taken care of. Once that goes down, she'll be fine, but Megan goes ahead and drops that rage. Just to make sure gets that queen sort of boosted back up and clearing some of this out a little bit faster. She'll step up in just a moment and get onto that air defense, and then the queen's going to engage as well. So having those healers raised right there is a big deal anyways. That queen goes down right here, gets on that storage, and then gets onto that air defense. From there, going to continue her walk around the base, just coming down to the bottom. That X-bow really the only thing hitting on her right now, and that's not that big a deal with the healers there to protect her. So from here, Lettner come around, drops that one hog in there, wants to let, actually got a bomb trigger there. I probably wasn't really looking for that, but possibly. Gets that bomb triggered. I think probably wanted to get the CC troops there, but maybe not. We'll see. Not sure why nothing came out of there. But anyways, come down to the bottom here, working around. One balloon in there. I think, again, just trying to get in there and get that CC lured out. This one is actually going to make it. Drops the next range. Here comes the dragon right there. Just finally gets in range. That's what she was fishing for. The dragon comes out. The healers are rage, though, so that's all she needed. Does not even have to use her ability because of that. Those rage healers. You see how quickly they're just healing her right back up as soon as she takes damage. And then now the healers are getting in range of this first air or this second air defense, but it's no big deal. The queen is taking very, very little damage. It's just splash damage, and really her job is done at this point. Once she gets that second air defense taken care of, she's gotten two ADs, a pretty good chunk of the base, and the CC troops and the enemy queen taken care of. So mission accomplished. The healers go down. They go down. She uses the ability. Takes out a few skeletons with it, and then whatever she gets over here as far as this archer tower and wizard tower is just sort of a bonus. Coming in from the top, drops that king down. Just want to get that archer tower taken care of, and then it's time to send in the lava hounds and the balloons. Just coming in at a couple different angles. You see the CC troops, the balloons emptying out here onto that king. But really, again, no big deal. The king did not have a mission there besides that archer tower. Just do a little bit of tanking for her balloons as they came in. Does have the two, or excuse me, the one freeze left. That first lava hound just gets roasted by that single inferno tower right there, building up on some balloons, and right got a little aggressive over here on the second inferno tower with the freeze spell. Tried to get that air defense as well, just missed it, but somehow actually pulls it off anyways. Drops those haste spells, make sure those balloons are getting there very, very quickly. They get it taken down, and then all that's left is that one inferno tower, the sweeper, but that doesn't really matter. The Tesla is all that's left. The balloons just have to get over there. Goes ahead and drops the rage. Still had that lava hound out in front tanking, which takes that black bomb and just bust and gives her more pups and the 3-star beautiful attack by Megan Mo Money. All right, moving on to some more Town Hall 10 action. Looking at Wanders X taking on their number 9. Again, Bill Balloon, pretty much the go-to. Drops down the queen. This is what you're going to see on most all of these attacks. You figure out a way for your queen to get in there to get an air defense, two air defenses preferably, and then use maybe a kill squad if you need to get in, take the queen out. An inferno tower would be a bonus, but that's just sort of the I don't know what you would call it, just the blueprint, the pattern that you're going to see on all these Town Hall 10 3-stars that we're starting to try to get more of. The CC troops come out right there, drops the poison down. The queen's obviously going to take care of them as well. You see, Wanderers only has a 38, 36 King and Queen, so not maxed out on this. Very high-level King and Queen, but not completely maxed out and still getting the 3-star, so that's impressive. On the left side over here, watch as the Giant goes down. A few Wall Breakers to open everything up, and that minion just clearing out some trash buildings. Queen takes care of all that stuff. She comes back around. Now you can see it easily there right by that Town Hall. She's going to be able to get to that air defense, so that's sort of what this Queen Walk was about, was taking out some of those trash buildings, taking out some defenses, and ultimately getting to that air defense right there. And getting it taken care of. On the left side, this is going to be all about killing the queen, and obviously the second air defense is right there handy, so we'll see if they can get in there and get that done right here. Just for a moment, she's in range of that inferno tower, so she's not getting a lot of healing done, but steps right out, drops the rage spell, and that gets her boosted back up as soon as those healers get in that rage. So right there, boosted right back up. A couple more point defense to get on her, but no big deal. She's going to take them down. And she's about to meet up where Wanderers wants, so he can start dropping in that king, dropping in his kill squad here, and just moving his way into the base. So, again, this is about getting in there and getting that queen taken care of, and that air defense that's sitting right there. Obviously, the queen, as she joins up, is going to have easy access to that as soon as she wraps around the corner here. The healers are still keeping her up. Now, they are in range of this air defense, and they're going to go down really, really quickly to this air defense and that X-bow. But, again, the queen right there on top of it as soon as she can takes that air defense down. Now the king's there. Just waiting for that giant bomb to go off, then uses the ability, which is smart, and just tries to let him beat through this wall. But those skeletons come up, they slow everything down. But again, the queen still has a healer on her. She's got the range. She can easily use her ability, which he has saved this whole time, take out that defending queen, and there you go. Two air defenses down, the queen's down, the CC troops are down. It is time for the lava hounds and the balloons. Sending them in, just hasting everything to try to push it in really, really quickly. and let those balloons move quickly between defenses is the important part there. And then has the two freezes right there. Beautiful freeze. Gets the X-Bow, gets the air defense, gets the Infernal Tower. And by the time all of that wakes up, the balloons are on top of them and they are in big, big trouble. The rage spell for the offside and saving that freeze spell for where he needs it on that last Infernal Tower right there as the balloons start approaching gives him a little haste, love, and the freeze spell. Again, once that thing thaws out, it is all over but the crying. And look at this. Just smash this base. Look at all the balloons left. And pups running everywhere. Just a beautiful attack. Really, really nice job. Great queen walk. Good value for it. And then just beautiful heal placement, or spell placement. Just making everything work just like you want it to. So good job, Wanders. All right. Looking at some Town Hall 9 action. Scorpion wins, taking on number 14. And we've seen a lot of Lalloon, but we haven't seen a Town Hall 9 Lalloon yet. So let's take a look at one of those. Three rage spells, three haste spells, and a poison is all Scorpion needs. Dropping down the queen here at the bottom, the giant and a few wizards and a minion to just create that funnel, push everything in. Queen where he wants her to go. So right there, that gets created. He knows she's going to go here. And then using the wall breakers to open up this compartment, he wants this queen to actually step in, not just to walk around, but to go up there and get that air defense in the middle. And what he's going to do is continue on with this, which is beautiful because he wants these two outside compartments cleaned up so that he can get into the core there. So right here, a couple of more wall breakers the cannon on the left was just far enough away he could target that middle section there, and with the rage spell, gets right in there. Then you see the golem come out, but it doesn't matter. The point here is that that middle section's open up where the queen can walk in there, and the first air defense is down. Now she has access to two more, gets that golem taken care of, which is really just a time sink. There's no threat to the queen there, just letting it go down, letting it go down. And then right here, she is going to step up and start focusing on those storages. Actually, I think those wall breakers did not get that wall taken. He tried it there. I don't know if the wizards got in range or what, but that did not go down. The king goes in. He's going to go ahead and drop, another rage here. Yep, right there, another rage. Get that queen built back up. Let that king beat through that wall. And now she's in the core. Now he's in the core. The queen's able to get in there and, again, has access to two more air defenses. So with this kill squad, this little section that he's done here, going to get all of those Teslas, those point defense, those towers. The queen right here coming over. The king's trying to get in there onto her. Gets the enemy king taken care of. These X-Bows are going to get taken care of. A third rage spell on his queen in healers. Guys, this is it now. With the queen walk sort of nerf. It was a nerf. Yeah, you can call it that. It was a nerf. Rage, I mean, it just sort of brings it right back. There's nothing that can stop it. If you've got, four healers and your queen and they're raged, they can just deal with anything. And so right there, you see how much value that was for that queen, just sort of charge, I guess you would call it. Uses the queen's ability right there, gets that X-Bow, and then boom, that last air defense. So three ADs down, the CC troops taken care of, the queen taken care of. Everything is done. Only that one air defense remaining. Put a couple of lava hounds down on it, and then just balloons targeting all of these outside defenses, which they start disappearing very, very quickly. First lava hound's about to explode, but no big deal. There's another one waiting right behind it, so that air defense will start targeting it. A haste to let those balloons get right in there, and then the last few balloons around the outside here. Look at all those balloons cutting through the middle of that base. Love it. You can just tell this base is toast. Right there, the Tesla goes down, the wizard tower goes down, only that archer tower left to worry about, and a lot of balloons staring it down. They all congregate on it. Kaboom, it is gone. Fast forward, because that is a beautiful 3-star by Scorpion Wins. Good job, buddy. All right, we'll let that clean up, and we'll check out a couple more attacks. Couple more for you guys. Let's look at Sloffles taking on number 23. And again, man, I didn't even know this is like a Go Lalloon themed video. Should have named it that or something. I think they've got some different ones towards the end here, but I should have stuck with it and just showed you guys all Go Lalloon this time. Didn't notice it till just now though. Comes in at the top with a couple of golems, wizards to create the funnel, normal stuff that we always see, and a minion on the right side there. A few wall breakers open it up. They start moving forward, and the queen is right behind him. The king gets placed down now, and you see the jump spell clearly going right for that queen, and this is because she's sandwiched nicely between two air defenses. Wants to go ahead and get that as well. CC troops coming out. Poison spell goes down. The queen's going to deal with them pretty quickly with that rage to just speed things along with the few wizards that are in there and the queen. They just melt those CC troops. You see the air defenses about to start going down right here. The first one being targeted by that king. A few more swipes. Boom, it's gone. One on the right gets taken out by wizards and golems. And then the lava hounds and the balloons just working their way through. A couple of lava hounds on that first air defense. Balloons to back it all up. A rage spell and a haste spell. And then on the right side, a few more balloons. And then that last lava hound going down just to continue to tank for all those balloons. You see that it goes to that one air defense. It's got just a little damage left on it right there. It goes down and then to that last one. Does soak up a black bomb. So it's pretty low health. But the balloons are starting to close in just in time. It gets exploded, and then the last few balloons on the backside for cleanup. Doesn't actually take out that archer tower, but gets it very, very low. And as the queen steps up, one shot, boom, it's gone. Uses the ability, and that is that. Beautiful attack by Slothfuls, and continuing with a Golaloom three-star theme with him. So let's see what's next here. I think we're about to venture away from the Golaloom, but I could be wrong. We'll see what we got. Garsk, taking on 27. Oh, a Golaloom. What do you know? This is like an all-air attack episode. I can't believe I've never, I don't know if I've ever done this. I didn't even do it intentionally. That's crazy. I just like these attacks for some reason this time. But I like this one because it's a Zap Quake. You see putting the Quake down right there and a couple of Zaps, taking that air defense out and then coming in from the top side with the two Golems, the Wizards to create the funnel, the Queen coming in, and you see that obviously wants to get in here and get these other two air defenses taken down. It has the Jump Spell to let things move right in and also to get to that enemy Queen. Which is down there, sort of towards the bottom half of the base. So, but it's still a semi-centralized queen, which allows you to come from the opposite side and still get to her, which is why you don't do that. Golem's moving forward. King's coming in now at this point. You see a Golem might go flying there. A rage for his kill squad, and then the CC troops are coming out. Just use the king's ability. They're starting to go down pretty quickly. The queen's got to help take care of him. The few of the wizards that are in there are going to help out a little bit. The second air defense already dead. Right there goes the third one. The queen's locked onto that expo. It's going to go down in just a moment. And you see, I think the enemy queen, yeah, is already dead. The queen's stepping into that pocket there. And here come the lava hounds and the balloons just real quickly. Just boom, boom, two lava hounds. Targeted balloons for all those outside defenses. And then that haste spell to move them right into that air defense. It goes down. And that is pretty much a wrap for this base. There's only, what, one, two, three, four, five defenses that can even attack these balloons left. There's a little cluster right over here on the backside, but he's going to wait, let these large groups start to get in range, and then come in the backside with those last few balloons on that wizard tower to protect his large group of balloons, which is the right thing to do. Beautiful job, Garsk. Take out that last archer tower and Tesla, and that is a wrap. Cleanup time. Pups are around the outside. Queen's in the middle there. She takes a couple giant bombs, but stays on her feet and helps out just a little bit towards the end. So excellent, excellent attack. All right, one more. And this one is an air attack, but it's not a Golaloom. So I'm sorry if that was a little boring for you guys. I hope not. I liked all those attacks. And this one is going to be a Cheatham, normal Cheatham special dragon attack with a Zap Quake. And coming in from the bottom with those dragons, just sending them right in, right at that queen. Obviously, she's going to engage and start drawing them in. And then right here, look at Zap, 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 and that Quake right in the middle, which is going to reach both of them, takes out two air defenses. So now only two air defenses to go. The queen is no more. She's down there in the bottom, just got roasted. And so now he's going to come in from the top with his kill squad. King and queen come down. And a few hogs on the left side for this left air defense. Just wants to get in there as soon as things start targeting his king and queen. Going to send those in. And then on the right side is where he's going to send that one lava hound that he has in the CC. And then just start sending those balloons in. So there you see the left side air defense being targeted. It's going down. Here comes the lava hound and the balloons. King's sort of walking around the one outside. Queen's going the other way. Which is good. That'll work. Take out trash buildings. Do a little bit of tanking. Right here, they're closing on that air defense. The last air defense, you see all the dragons down low still continue to do work. Nothing can really deal with them besides those air defenses. And once they're gone, it takes forever for the rest of this defenses to take them out, especially when balloons are picking off defenses one by one. So right there, as you can see, that is that. One expo in the middle. It goes down to a whole lot of balloon drops and clearly an easy, easy three-star. Beautiful attack by our boy Cheatham. Good job, buddy. All right, there you go, guys. An all-air extravaganza. I guess next recap, I need to do a lot of ground attacks for you guys. Hope you enjoyed it. 32 to 15 on the three-stars. Good job on the 8th that we didn't grab. A lot of those were Town Hall 11s and some Town Hall 10s. So good job to everybody at One Hive. Good try to Bobson family. Keep it up, guys. Hope you all like the video. Until next time, Jake from One Hive doing my best to help you guys suck less.